The Innovation Studio believed in us, so we started to believe in ourselves more.
Our team, with the help of the Innovation Studio, turned dreams into actionable research and development, prototypes into field-ready units that were deployed at 22,000 feet in Peru in just under a year.
I've always kind of seen the Innovation Studio as kind of a metaphorical home.
Innovation is not an elitist sport, and we believe at the Innovation Studio that we need to democratize innovation across our university. We provide funding and resources to every team who wants to pitch their idea to us, and we're going to help them by giving them the support, the permission, and the validation they need to get started.
Working on different projects every day gives me freedom, and I love to be able to have new challenges every day and to be able to help people bring new ideas to life. Our impact definitely spreads a lot farther than I think we ever thought it would, especially this early on.
My project is C3D, and we 3D print models for people who are blind. The models that we print are of things that people would like to see, but are kind of hard to understand in real life through touch. So things that are too small, like cells, DNA, snowflakes, and things that are too big, like buildings, the Taj Mahal, the Capitol building, other famous landmarks, maybe things like maps, like a map of the world. Some people even want to know, can we 3D print fire? As we increase accessibility, it really helps people who are blind, blind students, and blind teachers become more included in the conversations about engineering, about science. Whenever we can include more people in conversations and we can understand different perspectives, then it really helps with our understanding of the world, so then we can make better decisions in science, technology, and engineering. I actually sought out the Innovation Studio when I was a senior in high school. I was looking for a college that had a makerspace. I wanted to find a college that had access to 3D printers, so that way I could continue my idea to create C3D. I believe the Innovation Studio is extremely vital to putting ideas into action.
My project involves fusing science and engineering to monitor the rapid changes underway across high mountain glacier environments, with a focus on not only how those glaciers are changing, with an emphasis on water resources and how the destabilization of these ice masses might affect public health and safety via natural hazards. Tropical glaciers are one of the best unbiased indicators that we have of climate change. These massive pieces of ice around the equator they're an unbiased thermometer. They're melting, they're wasting away. As the rate of change continues to accelerate, I think it's really critical that we come up with plans that are more aimed at taking proactive measures to mitigate this risk than strictly reacting when things go bad. I had designed a high altitude, heavy payload autonomous aircraft, as well as a terrestrial laser scanner, all of which could be powered via the sun, solar power. And so in 2019, we successfully conducted a series of sustained, highly coordinated observations from instruments in orbit, in the air, and on the ground. Really, I cannot think of an initiative at Ohio State that has brought more people together across disciplines, across campus, than the Innovation Studio.
Through the Innovation Studio, I have worked on probably a dozen different projects. The one that is the most active at the moment is my Rollator project. And a Rollator is a walker on wheels. It helps me get from point A to point B better. We tried to make it accessible even in the things that we used to build these extra parts. It runs on drill batteries, and the motors are from some children's scooters. The Rollator project, yes, it touches on me very personally, but it speaks to a broader conversation that I'm definitely trying to get more people invested in, where it speaks to how important accessibility is in our society. You know, to me, disability doesn't really exist. It's inaccessibility that's the problem. Kind of the realization of all of that as I was going through my own personal health challenges really led me to start creating solutions. This world was not likely to accommodate for me, and so if I wanted to live in this world, I better start trying to build one that was inclusive to all of us. I grew so much because of the Innovation Studio's support, and I think that all educational institutions need something like the Innovation Studio.
We definitely are starting to hit our stride and make some good steps moving forward.
We knew that our students were great. We knew that our faculty were great. We just weren't sure of how quickly and how broadly the work that they're doing would disseminate across the world.